Hallelujah. And I have no more glory. They shall. They should be the. I don't want to be with you.
If you have not received your blessing, lift up your hand. It's not mine. I want to give you something. If you have not received your blessing, have you received your blessing? Have you received it?
Hallelujah.
The journey is going further.
This
is the second day. According to his word. In the commands of God,
for
this church to start this
procedure,
as the Spirit is talking to us,
he
spoke with us that we should prepare our oil to use. I beg God for us to take it to tomorrow so that we can use the spiritual materials that is there.
Hallelujah.
Then we can finish
everything
tomorrow. Before I call my father, the ushers, they should distribute the orange and the water in there. They should distribute the orange and the water. When I will call my father, that is his name.
God's own pouch.
Father, I thank
you for this opportunity. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I ask you right now that if you're not receiving something, lift up your hand. There is something I want to give you. But you're not lifting up your hand. Clap your hand. You couldn't clap to God. Let's stand up all. Let's stand up all. Let's stand up all.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There's no more grace upon this earth. When they tell you there's a grace on this earth, they are pushing you forward. Some grace you have is to talk to God, is to praise God. The grace you have is to praise God, to talk to God.
Hallelujah.
I will call my father in the Lord. He will journey with us.
We will
work together.
The
30 minutes grace to talk. Hallelujah. We will work all together. We will work all together tomorrow. We are postponing everything to tomorrow. Everything shall come to you tomorrow. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Let's pray for him. Let's pray for him. Let's clap for him.
Hallelujah!
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 Father, Lord Almighty, we give you thanks, we give you praise. We give you glory.
glory, honor, and adoration. For it's you that have made it possible for us to be able to gather for your presence. Father, Lord God, accept our thanks and praise in Jesus. I will still want to thank my fathers in the Lord, mothers in the Lord, for gracing this occasion. They said many are called, but few are chosen. Count yourself a blessed one because you are chosen tonight. So that your name may be a new name. In Jesus' mighty name. Can we just lift up our hand and say, I just want to say, Baba oh, I just want to say, as they were deliberating upon those names, and they've all spoken well. May the Lord God, I'm going to bless you all, sir. Yeah. I'm going to give you more wisdom and understanding. Yeah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah. I was not here yesterday when the definition of name was given, or the characteristics or the signals of names. But one thing I've come to add tonight is, a new name is a name that is divinely chosen. Amen. Yeah. A new name that is what? Divinely chosen. We all have names. So why do we need names? There are some people now, when they want to change their name, they will tell you, no. Can you change the name of McDonald's? No. Can you change the name of Guinness? No. Do they need that? Do they want their name to be changed? They don't want their name to change because such names are called renowned names. Amen. Yeah. Renowned names. Name will never change. So why are you here for your name to be changed? Those are the questions you must ask yourself as a Christian. Before you can be talking of name changing or a new name, which means your current status and names is not perfect. Amen? Amen. If your name is renowned, why do I need to change my name? Then when you talk of name and the characteristics of name, you know that some people have no name at all. Amen. Thank God you have name. Say, thank God I have name. There are some people that they don't have names. However, one will never miss out on Luruko. Amen. These people that I'm talking about, they are in the Bible. People that have no names. We are prophets that has no name. A prophet of God that has no name. And he performed brilliantly well, but something happened along the line. He killed himself. Okay? In the book of 1 Kings, chapter 13, don't be writing down because the time is very short. I just want to go home tonight with a very powerful inclination and intention about changing of name. Amen? You have people with name, people without name, and people with great name. Amen? Chapter 13 from verse 14. A king was misbehaving in that territory, and God sent a prophet, a very genuine prophet, to that king. Sir, 1 Kings chapter 13 from verse 14, sir. Amen. And when the prophet got there, he displays the message of God to that king, that look, God said the altar you built is not acceptable to him. Desist from that kind of altar. And the king was trying to contend with that prophet, and his hand was withered. Amen. Amen. And this prophet has no name. Do you know why? After performing all what God has sent him, God said, as you go to this king, if you are offered any food, don't eat. Don't come back the same way you went in. Okay? He went in and performed brilliantly before everybody, and he said, wow, what a great prophet. But this prophet, his name was not mentioned. And immediately, there's another great prophet in that territory. His son happens to be in that revival, like we are here today. And they ran back to his father and said, Daddy, oh, you are a prophet, you are not a man of God. The prophet of God came today and he displayed the power of God mightily.
And the father said, what? He said, but what happened? He said,
why did the prophet now?
He said, they asked the prophet to eat. He said, God said, do not eat. And the same way you should not follow the same way. The pastor said, saddle my ass for me. And he went and met this young prophet while he was resting. He said, God, God, my son, I'm even a prophet. He has no name as well. Amen. This is very, very logical. People of underworld, you cannot get what you don't know their names. May you never come in contact with people that will be able to turn your glory and destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
The man says, arise. He said, God has sent you, has only sent me to you, that my son will perform brilliantly. Come and eat and rest. And as he was doing so, a lion killed him and devoured him. The lion of this world will not kill you.
Amen.
That is the prophet. He has no name.
Amen.
Cain and Abel's sister has no name. Noah's wife has no name. Abraham's mother has no name. Lot's wife and daughter has no name. Potiphar's wife, the one that Joseph was about to sleep with, what is her name? We don't know. David's mother, only know she did like a baby. You know she did she for last year would for one night stand. Amen. One night stand. Are you listening to me? David on one night stand in Uruko, yeah, I was on the building. But the name of the mother was not mentioned in the Bible. Hence in Psalm 51, he said, you know I should that will give me. You know a share. Yeah, we should know me. When they asked Jesse to present his children for kingship of Israel, he refused to bring David out. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We shall have a new name.
Amen.
The Nabatean shepherds, those that saw the stars of Christ, they have no names. The sisters, the stepsisters, and the cousins of Jesus Christ our Lord, they will have no name. The Ethiopian eunuchs, the one that Philip served his house and interpreted Christ for, has no name. Pontius Pilate's wife, the one that told the husband, look, my husband, this man had not committed any sin. Wash your hand off his case. Her name was not mentioned. Which means, scripturally, biblically, we have people without names. But here you are. You have names. Amen.
Amen.
Why do you need a new name? You need a new name because of a new divine intervention. Because you are created to display the manifold wisdom and knowledge of God. Not because of anything. Amen. Hence, you need a new name. Or if not for that, your name is enough for you to carry and to bear. For the Bible says you were created. Say, thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power. For thou hast created all things and for the plague of the earth. You are created for the pleasure of God. Amen. And so shall it be for you in Jesus' name. You need a new name so that you're able to guide the divine and purpose of God to the larger end. Amen. Martin Luther King, my brother said it just now, we have two of them. He only mentioned one. He mentioned the one of America. We have Martin Luther King in Germany. He's a Presbyterian pastor. His name is only Martin Luther. He worked assiduously and effectively in the land of Germany, but they said that they formed a party after his name called Christian Democratic Union in Germany. So what kind of name do you want to have? Martin Luther Jr. fought for racial segregation in America and for a tremendous change of non-violence. Amen.
Amen.
Because of him, there was no longer, that is why today now we are able to produce a black man in the White House. We now have Martin Luther Day in the United States of America. That is the kind of name we need to aspire to become. And when you, there is one thing people are not touching when you mention names, right? If you want your name to be changed or you want a new name, there must be a sacrifice. Daniel said, those
that know the God they serve. They shall be what? They shall be strong and they shall do exploits. In order for you to do exploits, there must be a sacrifice. Without a sacrifice, there can never be a breakthrough. Without a breakthrough, you can never have a new name. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
You want to have new name. New name, but the Bible says that faith without work is what? Is dead. If I want to see Oguni.
If you like, you can come to this parish or a parish or any church, redeem or anywhere people like for morning to night, 7 days in a week. If you are not working, you cannot achieve anything in life. You can never have a new name. Two people graduated from the same university. They were looking for a job. They met a man who just bought a plot of land and he's about to build a factory on that land. Say, guys, you said you are looking for work. Well, the only thing you can do for me for now is to help me clear the bush and cut the trees. Okay? You gave them money, 10,000 naira each, to start as a deposit. The born again Christian one went into the portion that belongs to him, started praying and speaking in tongues. He was praying and speaking in tongues. The other guy went back to the city and bought a cutlass and sharpened it and came back and started clearing the bush, cutting the trees and everything. At the end of the day, the owner of the land came. So, wow! What is happening here? That God will say, oh, my God said he's going to order the bread. My God will supply all my needs according to his own. Philippians 4:19. What? How do you refer to that scripture, man? Where do you have it in the Bible? Philippians 4:19. That is 4:19. Amen? That is Christian 4:19. It's a very dangerous quote. Because they will not put the precise passage before that verse, Colossians 19. He said, your work, your offering, your alms has come unto me through my son Epaphras. He said, because of what you have done, my God. But now you've not done anything, and you said your God shall supply. What is not going to supply anything? Amen.
Amen.
And the one speaking in tongues, God brought him. The man at the end of the day employed the other secular man to become the managing director of that company because he refused to deceive himself. As a Christian, you need to make sacrifice for your name to be changed. Amen?
Amen.
And that will be your portion tonight. I want you to go home with a different mindset. Don't believe in religious animosity. Don't believe by coming to the house of God to pray without work will save you. No, you are not created for that. When God created Adam in the Garden of Eden, he made sure that that Adam was in his presence. As a man, as a woman of substance, you must always make sure that you are in the presence of God always. Two, the Bible made us realize that he was to take care of the trees and the fruit of that garden, which means as a man, you must walk. From the onset, before you can be talking of marriage, God must make sure that in the presence of God, you must walk, you must have the, what is glory of God? What do you refer to as glory? People call glory, 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 what is glory? Glory of God is not a light, it's not a light that is shown. No. The glory of God is the ability of mankind to be able to ascend the throne of God. Amen. The Bible said, when Moses went up to the mountain and he came back, his countenance was changed because he had seen the glory of God. Amen?
Yeah.
That is it. That is what we need as a believer. You don't have to be deceived. We've been deceived for a very long time because of this word Christianity. It's making a lot of people to become lazy. A lazy man cannot have his name to be changed. Amen?
Amen.
We have the madman of Gadara. He's a madman, he has no name. But in him were several different kinds of legions of demons. Amen?
Amen.
Will that never be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus? We must walk for our name to be changed. It's the key anchor point of this revival. Amen?
Amen.
We need to walk. A lot of people, my brothers and guys, they've mentioned names in the Bible. Adam, this, that, Jacob. We all know their stories. But one thing we are unable to identify is why was that name? Zechariah was in the house of God for how many years? Walking day and night. He was not sleeping. In the book of Proverbs, he said, a little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of hand. So shall your poverty be. Amen. Everybody was on the morning that we're ready to go to work. You are sitting in your bed at 9 o'clock. Yeah, you must. Man. And now you say you want your name to be changed by deceiving yourself. Prayer, English, teacher, or drama. If you like to pray from that time, Armageddon will come. You're not going to get anything. Write it down. Just stop yourself. Drink, smell your coffee. Put on your shoe. Go out there. Look for work. And as you are looking for that, begin to pray that God, I want you to be my help. You are the present help in times of need. And I know with you all things are possible. Oh yes, God, as I'm going out today, I want you to give me a new name. I want to be a managing director. I want to be an entrepreneur that will be able to employ people. And as you are saying all these things, and you are not sitting in a place, you are moving, Exodus. You are moving from one place to another. God will continue to bless the hand work of the hand work in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah, sir. Hallelujah.
Proverbs 6, chapter 6, verse 9.
Yes.
How long will you lie down?
Yes.
You sluggard.
Thank you.
When will you get up from your sleep?
Thank you.
A little sleep, a little slumber.
A little folding of hands.
A little folding of hands.
So shall your poverty be.
And poverty will come on you like a bandit, as casty like an armed man.
Hallelujah. You want to have a new name. Now you are in this country where there is no scarceness of bread and milk. Amen.
Amen.
And I look at the people in this country, at times it baffles me the level at which they squander the glory of God. You are in the land where there is no scarceness of bread and milk according to the promise of God. And you are still lacking. You are in Nigeria. How many of you, when you are in Nigeria, were able to drink fresh milk? No, and let us be honest with ourselves. How many of you? Orange juice, 5 and 5. If you go to a party and they give you 5 and 5, you go back home with the cartoon with the pack. Amen. Just to show your family that I was there. Eh? Just to tell them that October, we got a party. See the 5 and 5. Amen. But now here you are able to make different kind of choices. Mom.
Hallelujah.
I don't want to take much of our time for that because this world is a roller coaster. We need to align ourselves properly with the tunes and the dictates of God Almighty. Otherwise, we'll be missing that. We'll miss it in eternity. We will not miss it in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
How many kind or type of name do we have? My mother in the Lord came and just nailed it on the head. We have different kinds of names. When you were born in your village, they call you Antisilifa, Antimorufa, Antigrace. You left home, you came to Lagos. Anytime your family wants to refer to you, Antieko, Sisieko. Nobody say, Antiwato, Aleko, Tideo. This is the Adoblin. Are these not new names? Are they your original names? But they are name of progress and not name of retardation. These are names of what? Progress, name of movement, and not name of retrogression or retardation. Amen?
Amen.
So which means you are progressing in the things of this world according to the dictates of heaven. Amen? They refer to you now as Mama Doblin, Baba Doblin. They did the same thing for Christ. They refer to Christ as Jesus of Nazareth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are a good Bible scholar. I love you. You come and ruin my school. Amen. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So it's not new that they call you Mama Dublin, Baba Dublin. It's a name of progress. It's a name that identifies. It's a divine name. We have all people that are called prisoners. That people that are called lunatics. That different kind of names. But God has not allowed God to call you a negative name but a positive name. And that positive name will going to affect your life and life of a generation in the mighty name of Jesus. Why must we have a new name? Why? And that is where I started myself. Why do we need to have a new name? You are here tonight, everybody say, the revival team is, we must have a new name. Some think having a new name that you will sleep tonight and God will wake you up like a woke Jacob and say, your name has been changed from Benjamin to Brigade. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You will wake up and start that you are dreaming. It's just a dream. You will sleep Benjamin. For a divine purpose. And who are those people that we change? That the people that God want to make use of for the next assignment, which is not easy. Check. My brother mentioned Jacob, mentioned a lot of names. Go and read them. Abraham, after how many years before him, you can see all what they passed through. If it is near you, if Abraham is not confident in himself, to be able to align separately with the things of God, God will not now call him that he should use his only begotten son as a sacrifice. And we'll be, no, me and you. If Holy Spirit, you said, yeah, job. I call no see what you can no get, I call for hallelujah, we did. All only, or my God, no fair care, fish, you so. Why do you show me? Did you go there at your last? Oh, Lucian, hey, we'll be so soon. Hey, Jimmy, I'm coming me. Oh no, 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 and you want to recover a new name. It's not possible. There are lots of price tag to a new name. It's not just easy. It's not by faith. It's by faith and by work. And God will empower us in Jesus. And God will help us all. Tonight I've come to tell you that there is no other name above the name of Christ. Amen. If you don't know, each and every one of us will now have a new name. What is the difference between sons of God and children of God? The Bible says, sons of God and children of God, which are right now. So, but what is the difference between children of God and sons or daughters of God? Who can tell? Can anybody help me with that? The difference between children of God and sons or daughters of God. Amen. We are born, each and every one of us. We are born as children in the book of Jeremiah chapter 1. He said, before you were conceived in your mother's womb, our Lord, I have known you and I have even called you by your name. So which means you are a child of God. Amen. Each and every one of us. But we are not all sons and daughters of God. Because sons and daughters of God must be earned. It's a title and a rank. You must be promoted to become a son of God. You must be promoted to become a daughter of God. I will show you. Amen.
Amen.
So, for today, we thank God you're supposed to be here tonight to aspire and to pray to become a son of God. So that will be your permanent divine new name. And that will be your portion tonight. Tonight, you are not going to leave this throne without you getting to that position. You'll be elevated to become sons and daughters of God. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In the book of Job chapter 1 verse 6, they said, and the sons of God were gathered together. They refer to them as sons of God. In Psalm 2 verse 7, you see Matthew. Okay, just take some scriptures so that I'll be able to differentiate between children and sons of God, please. Psalm 2 verse 7, sir. Let me start from Genesis. Genesis chapter 6, 2 to 7, the sons of God. Exodus 4, 22. He said, Israel is my son. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 14. I will be his father and he will be my son. 1 Chronicles, the same thing. Job 1:6 said the sons of God were gathered together. Psalm 2 verse 7. Matthew 5:9. Isaiah 6:35. If you want to be sons, the requirement to be a son of God, you find that in the book of Isaiah chapter 6:35. Let somebody read that for me, please. Isaiah chapter 6 verse 35. Amen. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 35. I'm rounding up. Isaiah what?
6.
Yes, verse. It's not up to 35. Luke 6:35. Then let somebody open Galatians 3:24 to 9. Galatians 3. Luke 6:35. Yes, sir.
Beloved, your enemies and do good.
Listen, it's more to be a son and daughter of God. That is the requirement. Yes, sir.
Beloved, your enemies and do good.
Yes.
And let open for nothing again. And your reward shall be great.
Yes.
And ye shall be children of the highest.
Yes.
For his kind unto the thankful and unto the evil.
Yes.
Be ye therefore merciful.
Uh-huh.
As your father also merciful.
You see it?
Judge not.
Yes.
And ye shall not be judged.
Amen.
Condemn not.
Yes.
And ye shall not be condemned.
Uh-huh.
Forgive.
Yes.
And ye shall be forgiven.
Amen.
Give.
Yes.
And ye shall be given unto you.
Uh-huh.
Good measure.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Shaken together and run over. Shall men give unto
to your bosom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is it. That is one of the requirements to be sons or daughters of God.
Must forgive.
You must forgive others. It is now discovered that a lot of people are unable to make heaven now because of unforgiveness. Amen.
Amen.
A lot of believers. I don't use the word Christian now, because Christian started from Antioch. But before then, we are all believers. The difference between the people of the old and the new is what? Can somebody tell me? Do we have believers in the Old Testament? Why do you say no? What do you mean by word believe?
Huh?
No. Believers means anybody that believes God is a believer. A Christian are the people that follow Christ after his death. That does not mean that they are more superior than those in the Old Testament. Okay? The difference between Old and New Testament is the Holy Spirit. Okay? That is the difference. Old Testament, there is nothing like Holy Spirit. But in New Testament, we have Holy Spirit. Amen? So that is the difference. But we are all believers. So if you want to become sons and daughters of God, do what that Bible says. Galatians chapter 3, 24 to 29. Briefly then, I close. 10 o'clock. Yes? Galatians 3, 24 to 29.
Therefore, the Lord was of our schoolmaster.
Yes.
Bring us unto prison.
Uh-huh.
That we might be justified by faith.
Uh-huh.
But after that faith comes, we are no longer under a schoolmaster.
Thank you very much. Once you have that, you are no longer under bondage. You are a new creation. Amen. Finally, your new identity can be found in Revelation 21:7. That is the end of the matter.
Revelation
21, verse 7. Christ said what? Unto John the Beloved.
He that overcometh shall inherit all things.
Yes.
And I will be his God.
Amen.
And he shall be my son.
Hallelujah. Can you hear it? He that overcometh. He said, I will be his father. So if God is now your father, what other new name are you looking for? I have a father who will